Tokyo. So I'm very delighted to welcome you this week and to walk you through this program of innovation service in Omotenashi 3.0.
And probably many of you will even suffer from pronouncing it correctly.
One thing which is very important in Ikebana is the beauty of subtraction.
The clear difference between the service and Omotenashi is illustrated in this photo. So the service is clearly defined between I and you. And this comes even from the etymology of service, where it's coming from the Latin word called servus. And servus is a slave, basically. So the service provider serves to the master. Whereas Omotenashi, there is no such distinction. It's really about we. It's really about co-creation. There is no distinction between the masters and the servant. It's really like you and I, really co-creating this environment. So it's really about this togetherness. So in Omotenashi, service providers and customers become one to create the wonderful harmonious atmosphere. Okay. And service providers and customers are seen as equal in stature and position, where neither is regarded as more powerful than the other. Okay, so even though I said that the Omotenashi is really about putting customers in the center, it doesn't mean that the customers are treated as a king.
Today we'll be experiencing a sado, which is the way of tea.
It is the first time for me experiencing this kind of Japanese tea ceremony. I'm coming from Mexico. I really want to learn more about the hospitality practices. With this tea ceremony, I kind of start to understand why the society in Japan behaves like that, like why do they have that practices. So I really enjoy it. I think that it is really a starting point from the learning the Omotenashi concept.
Is really about this service culture. And this service culture is embedded at the three levels. It's the firm level, industry level, and national level. So today and tomorrow is basically the Omotenashi 2.0, where you'll see this Omotenashi mindset everywhere in today's business, as well as the service scenes and the societal scenes across the Japan.
都市にも観光だったり土地の魅力っていうのはたくさんある。ただそれを楽しめるホテルがないっていうところに着眼点を置きまして、テンション上がる街中ホテルというコンセプトを日本語では言ってるんですが、 Get down with the localism っていうところで街を楽しむホテルっていうのを作ろうというふうになりまして、このOMOというブランドが立ち上がりました。
難しさはいっぱいありました。でその一番難しかったのはね、みんなが私たちはお掃除をする人だと思い込んでしまっていること。これをねまず脱却しないといけないと。私たちはねお掃除屋だと思っている以上は、上から言われたことを淡々とやっていればいいとかね、そういうふうにこう思い込んでしまうでしょ。だからねまずお掃除屋と思わせないということから始めたんだ。それが一番難しかった。それを最初にやったことであります。
The tour was very interesting. We saw many different parts of the whole process from behind the scenes, how they were trained, all the equipment that was used is super interesting.
The tour has been really good to get a good inside view. I really enjoyed the experience. The impressive part was actually to see the engines, but the most fun part was the photo area.
So all new cabin attendant trainees, regardless of the base or nationalities, will have a training in the tea room. When attending a tea ceremony, both the host and the guest should be prepared to show sincerity to each other. Knowing that this is once in a lifetime encounter that will never be repeated.
If you're a CEO at a very difficult situation, if you have to choose your employees' job security or equity holders' dividends and their ROI, their investment, which one are you going to choose? If you ask US companies, UK companies, equity holders are most important. And in order for them to do that, they fire their people, right? But if you ask a Japanese company, they complete the opposite. And they try to keep the employees as much as possible. So one of the questions that we asked yesterday, what was the toughest thing that ANA had to handle during the pandemic? And if you look around the world, airline industries, everybody, every single airline companies, basically firing their people first, right? But the ANA and Japan Airlines has never fired a single employee during this pandemic. They negotiate, they start lowering the salary a little bit. They're still an employee of ANA, but they're dispatched to the different industries.
As I mentioned that the 1919, Yamato was founded, the biggest innovation was 1976, we called the Takubin. Home Express Delivery Services. Yamato corporate philosophy, the most paramount concept is safety first and profit after. For your information, per day basis, total mileage we produce is equivalent to 52 times around the earth. Per day basis, handling about 6 million parcels per day. So meaning that the safety is at most importance for us. Logistics and transport business itself is a service industry. What we need, not only Yamato, but also Japan need, is how business and academia should join together to create the social platform. In this case, this program is very worth being a part of that, and it has always been a pleasure and also delighted to be a part of this. Now, I do hope that this program should further expand, and Yamato will be always ready to be a part of this program.
So towards the Omotenashi 3.0, yes, so the rise of service robots. I had asked you to stay in the Henna Hotel, which being recorded on Guinness as the first hotel to be managed by the robots. And also it's not only hotel, but there's also cafe. So if you go to like Shibuya area, there's like two or three cafes run by robots. Today we're going to robot restaurant where you will be having the lunch there. So we see more and more coming up where the services employing the robots even at the service encounter. It's not only about the backyards now.
日本橋にある普通のとても素敵なカフェです。ただ一つだけちょっと他のカフェと違うことがあります。それはロボットが接客をしていることです。正確にはロボットに入った人であり、人が接客をしています。あくまでこのロボットはアバターとしてこのカフェで接客をしています。 自分もできるかもしれないと思って手を挙げてくれた方々です。例えば ALS の方、SMA の方、それから脊椎損傷の方、さまざまな方がいます。で、こういった方たちがですね、この織姫の中に入って、織姫の操作者となって、お客様にコーヒーを運んで、ウェイター、ウェイトレスとして働くカフェを行いました。
さきさん、学生さんでいらっしゃいますか？
はい、そうです。
大学生ですか？
はい、大学生です。
ドンなどの取り組みは皆様に知っていただいてどんどん価値が上がっていく、つまりどんどん社会実装が進んでいくものであるので、こうやって来ていただけたり知っていただけることはすごく価値があります。2つ目として、こういったプログラムに参加されている方とこういった私自身個人としてご縁をいただけることは大きな価値だと思っていて、結構こういった機会でお目にかかった方とその後ビジネスのディスカッションが発展したりとか、そんなこともありましたので、今回のご縁もいいご縁になっていければなと思っています。
そしてなぜ我々が他の、ね、ホテル会社さんとは違ってロボットを活用し、オペレーションを行っているのか、まあ、ロボットを使いながらも、ローコストオペレーションで安全安心して、泊まれるホテルロビーに置かれている、チェックインマシーンなんですけれども、まあ、生産性効率性というところを考えればですね、こちらのチェックインマシーンだけでもいいんじゃないかという考えがありますが、チェックインオペレーションに関しましても、まあ、やはりお客様にワクワク、驚きを持っていただくようなエンターテインメント性を提供したいということで、こういったロボットを導入をしております。
So, when do you think that we're going to be able to have like a real Omotenashi 3.0?
At this stage, this, you know, reading between the line and reading the emotion and all that seems to be very difficult with the technology, and therefore, you know, adding warmth through usage of human, it seems to be very necessary to realize this kind of Omotenashi mindset and so forth. But even if technology is able to incorporate this emotional aspect, maybe we the human don't want to accept that as well. That's why the engineers were saying, as much as we want the service robots and technology how it want to be, that's how the technology is going to be like. So it's also dependent on how we want the, you know, all the technology to become. We'll see how the human evolution is going to go.
It's been a really good week for me. I have to say, I chose to come here to get the cultural experience because it's very different to Australia. And I've got all of that. Going to ANA's base to have a look at how they run their operations. It's fantastic. I work in the service industry myself. So to see something like that happen, you know, at another company is really exciting. And I think even to take the next step for learning about Omotenashi 3.0 and seeing the robots in action, the highlight for me was the Dawn Cafe. Incredible experience. I like the concept. I like what they're doing for people. And, you know, even though they're incorporating robots into everyday life, they're still keeping people in mind and letting people, you know, be a part of the whole process.
I enjoy the program very well. I think the best part for me is to see the history of Omotenashi from the tea ceremony cycle all the way to the future-looking robotic and automation experience. The favorite concept for me is the oneness, the host and the guest co-creation.
Like Nathan, I'm really taking away this co-creation piece. I think the mutuality of Omotenashi is something that's really extraordinary and applicable to so many different contexts, both forward in my career as a manager, so I'm trying to be really customer-centric, but also as I move forward as a customer and really like do my part to sort of come to the table ready to participate in service excellence.
Yes, please stay here and come back later, anytime in your life, ICS will always welcome you back, okay? So don't forget about it.